Welcome back to our backcountry clips. My name is Guy Willett with Dream Guides. Last time we looked at what kit we needed to bring with us into the backcountry, and this week we'll look at how we'll use some of that kit. So the first thing we'll look at is our skins. These are crucial to our backcountry skiing and making progress up the hill so we can then get the downhill. I normally store my skins in my rucksack in its own little bag just to keep the glue away from other things in my bag. Some people have an interweaving mesh between the sides of the skin. Personally, I don't use that as I find it's more trouble than it's worth. But here we have a skin. You can see on the back side it's quite sticky. And this is a side that will stick to the base of the ski. And on the front side we have a furry texture which will be in contact with the snow, and this is what provides us with grip. So on one direction it's smooth, which allows us to glide forward, and on the other direction it's rough, which allows us to grip as we go uphill. And finally we have a loop at the top which will hook over the tip of the ski. Some skins have a clip at the back which helps secure the skin at the rear of the ski so it doesn't come off so easily. Some skin models don't have this. It's purely a personal choice as to which one you prefer. So, putting on the skins, much easier when it's not windy. What we need to do is take our ski, and we need to make sure that the base of the ski is nice and clean and clear of snow, because if there's snow between the glue and the ski base, then the skin won't stick properly. And that's particularly true if it's very cold. So, quick wipe down of the ski base. See if we can. Then we grab our skin, pull it apart. And again, people do it different ways. I prefer to unravel my whole skin and hook over the top of the ski. As we put the skin on, we want to try and make sure there are no ruffles or ruckles in the skin. And we're trying to make it so that there's just a millimetre or so gap between the metal edge of the ski and the edge of the skin. And as you can see, I'm smoothing it down so that the glue sticks nicely and that there's no lumps and bumps, and there's no holes in this between the skin and the ski where snow can get in, which over the course of a day or a skin will prise the skins off. Great. Finally, I'll just put the tail of the skin on. There, we're pretty set. So that's one skin on. What I won't do now, particularly if I didn't have a tail securer, is I won't jab the ski into the snow, because it helps prise the skin off the back of the ski, which then means that the skin will come off later in the skinning. So I'll just put that straight down in the snow. So an alternative when it's very windy is putting on the skins section by section. So rather than prise apart the skin the whole way, I'll just prise it apart part way, make sure it's nice and clean. Then I can stick the first section on, then as I go down, I'll put a little bit more and a little bit more. It just means there's slightly less skin flapping around as we do it. Cool. And then once again, and then the back piece. And there's different ways you can start off having your skins to help with that. So likewise, to take the skin off when it's really windy, I can take it off in partial sections. Usually with my back to the wind, take it off from the back, and I can just fold it in shorter sections. And then we have a slightly less flappy skin to deal with. So I can now fold it into quarters or eighths, depending on how big I want it. And once again, if it's really cold, maybe I'll just keep my skin inside my jacket so my body warmth keeps the glue nice and warm. Conversely, if it's very hot, then I'll want to keep the skin in my rucksack. So I'll either put them directly into my rucksack, or more commonly, I can stick them back into my bag like this. And this keeps the glue and everything away from other things in my rucksack. So now that we have our skins on our skis and we're clicked into our bindings, we're ready to set off. Next week, we'll look at how we progress up the hill using our skins.